March Madness in full swing across the nation here in Warwick. We have our own basketball to cover, though. Ultamania returns after a three-year hiatus, one of the great traditions in Warwick basketball history, and I'm on the call to cover it. Tito Fernandez, Drew Border bringing you coverage of this basketball game. Drew, how are you feeling tonight?
I'm really excited. It's going to be something different for us tonight that we usually don't really get to cover, but it's going to be really exciting to see what our teachers that, you know, we've had the experience to, you know, be a part of in their classrooms, you know, compete on the basketball court. It's interesting to see their basketball skills going to come up tonight and play.
Yeah, unfortunately, the boys and girls basketball teams were not able to continue their run. We have our own stuff here. I'm now joined by the head coach of the high school Ultamania team, Chris Arvanites. Mr. Arvanites, how do you feel about your squad going into today's action?
I feel pretty good about it. I think we got a solid game plan going in. You know, we've been coordinating, practicing the entire week leading up to this. You know, we got a really good warm-up so far. So, we're ready.
Yeah, we see the sweat building up already. What's going on there? You see, you've been working your players a little hard?
Yeah, you know, I lead from the front, so I hope I didn't, you know, put it all out there already. I hope I still got a little bit left in the gas tank. We're going to be making a lot of subs tonight. You know, we got a lot of surprises, so be ready.
Every game we highlight a key player for our boys and girls basketball teams. If you had to choose a key player for your squad, who is that going to be? Who's your X factor?
Yeah, I wouldn't sleep on Andy Warren. Andy Warren is one of our mathematics and engineering teachers. I would not sleep on him. He is an excellent, excellent athlete and an even better teacher.
We are looking forward to seeing Mr. Warren play, but I'm going to throw it to Drew now, who's with our middle school coach.
I'm here with Principal Radon, who's the coach and also a player for the middle school team. Coach Radon, what does your team have to do tonight to come out successful against this high school squad?
Well, look, let's face it. We're coming off a huge win from a couple years ago. We're bigger, we're stronger, we're younger and faster. Just look at Principal Arvanites sweating over there already just from warm-ups. I'm super confident for today.
Yeah, I was going to bring that up, but you brought that up for me. You know, Principal Arvanites here is little, you know, has a good sweat going. You know, you're calm, collective, no sweat going.
There's no question about it. There's no question. We are calm, cool, and collective. We've got more heart, more skill. We're going to dominate tonight.
Who will be the key player for your middle school squad and elementary school squad tonight?
I'd love to tell you that. I really would, but you're just going to have to stay tuned and watch.
And there you have it.
This is going to be one of the most fun games you've ever seen. The gym is packed. They are ready to go head-to-head. It's the middle school and the elementary schools versus our Warwick Valley High School. Coming up next.
Oh, handshake.
Everyone knows using drugs is bad for you. Despite this, over 90,000 people are killed by them each year. 90% of teenagers have claimed to have an experience with peer pressure, and I'm confident you will know someone who has been as well. This being said, drugs will negatively affect your physical health, social health, and much more. An organization called Hope Haven seeks to improve the amount of substance abuse in America. By working with them, we can make that happen. Always keep it positive by making the right choice.
Well, Drew, this is the loudest I have ever heard this gym in my life.
I don't think there's a single high school fan here in attendance. I think this is all middle school and elementary school fans, which is might be bad. You know, I think this might be a home game in the high school for the middle school and the elementary school. But, you know, I think the high school will make this work. But
absolutely,
this is something we've never done, you and I, and it's going to be really fun. Looking forward to it.
The noise in this gym is absolutely absurd.
It's insane.
And let me set the stage for the viewers. We are right next to the speaker.
Yes.
Like, normally we're set up at half court. And today we're in the corner. So we have the big speaker above us. And it is loud. I think, Drew, I think we have a lawsuit case for hearing loss.
Oh, 100%. 100%. Definitely. The middle school and elementary school team's getting called out first, which is kind of weird. I thought the high school would get called out first, but.
Well, no, you know, you save the home team for last, right? And we are, I hope, the home team. I saw a bunch of, I saw a couple small pockets of our fans. Huge crowd reaction there.
That was pretty funny.
Yeah.
They thought Mr. Garcia thought he was getting called out being the all-section varsity football player, but it was actually Coach Patafio, who's a whole studies teacher in
and modified
middle school. And yeah. also coaches high school. So
now, as you can see, as the players walking out, they do not have numbers on the back. And me and Drew, we try to be, you know, good citizens, good people at the school, but we don't know everyone out there. So we apologize in advance for the many times that we are not going to know what teacher has the ball, what teacher is doing it. That was a big ovation. I believe it's Miss Fox with the middle school. Guidance from Miss Fox.
Yeah, it's Miss Fox's daughter, the head guidance counselor.
There's Miss Beck, softball, former softball player, currently, I believe, an assistant coach. And we call that.
Coach Kelly.
Yeah.
Big season for his Warwick lacrosse team. You know, hoping to repeat. I think they're going for fourth straight section title.
Yeah, that sounds about right to me. They just absolutely dominate. Lost a lot of talent this year, but have a ton of great players left. And there's a big ovation. There's Garcia getting called out. High five on the teammates.
I think it separated the All-State and All-Section from Patapio and Coach Garcia because All-State, you know.
Yeah. There's Coach Zoom. He was my wrestling coach this season. he's a character for sure. I don't know what to expect from him. I think he's going to be fouling a lot of people out there. I think he's going to play very physical. He'll be a fun player to watch.
Yeah, Coach Sirico said he's probably the biggest trash talker on the court, which I don't know if that's too hard to believe.
I can absolutely see it. Right now running out Coach Mann, modified basketball coach. We'll have a modified basketball player coming on in a minute, or in a couple quarters rather, but she's done some good things there.
Sanfordville Coach Sean Myers.
There's Mr. Myers, Sanfordville gym teacher. I've gotten to know him very, very well back when I was in middle school. He's a very good guy and also a big time basketball player. We'll talk about that more a little later. He'll be out there a lot.
This is my MVP pick for the game. I'm going to call it right now. Mr. Rauschenbach is going to be the MVP of this game.
Now, what do you think makes him stand out? What do you see in him, besides the obvious height?
When I was in eighth grade, this teacher, Mr. Rauschenbach, he used to almost talk trash to the students in advisory class on how he dropped 40 points in a men's league basketball game. So, you know, me, Ryan Fleming, and a bunch of other kids. So he's got to back it up. He did back it up one game when we were in, I think it was eighth grade, or freshman, but... You know, it's interesting to see what he can do, you know.
Yeah.
He might say, you know, he's getting older. Some of the other teachers have said that. See if he can, you know, carry on what he's doing. But we'll see what happens.
We'll see. You can't talk smack without being able to back up. See if you can. There's Mr. Radon. We talked to him a minute ago. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is your middle school and elementary school team. Just look at that stand. Those stands. Absolutely nuts.
It's crazy.
That's about triple the attendance of our boys' basketball game. It's nuts. And the other side is absolutely packed too. You're not going to see it on camera, but incredible.
Mr. Warren getting called out right now. He was Coach Arvanites, or Principal Arvanites, but Coach Arvanites tonight. He was the pick of the game for the high school team.
We have a lot of Mr. Warren stories today to get to. Talk to him a lot over the years. He's going to be a fun guy out there. And we're booing the high school team.
There's not a single high school fan here, which is very disappointing.
I saw Maza out there. I see Christian Piranha, the ninth grader. I saw a couple people, I think, in my grade, but the younger kids showing up in big droves here.
From our custodial team, Chris White.
And how about the custodian? We're really booing the custodian. Come on. Mr. White, the custodian, goes out there to boo. He, I hope, is a good player out there on the court tonight.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see. You know, you see him.
Oh, and here we go, Mr. Tobin. Running out. Love to see it. And another very familiar face in the channel running out after Mr. Tobin. Here's the Candyman. Ryan Candy, the man whose job Drew took, and we're going
to
bring him on.
Dirty like that.
We're going to bring him on later in the broadcast. You two are going to fight it out. Hopefully we get that on camera.
Yeah.
Here's our swim coach running out. Got swim team, something good things to do. Jesse Abramson swimming for Fordham.
I did not know Coach Vanderstar was an all-section linebacker.
I did not either. You wouldn't guess it. Another guy you guys have seen on a hockey show with Andrew.
And now guidance counselor in high school, Nick Panessi.
My guidance counselor.
Yeah.
Love Mr. Panessi. What a great guy, great guidance counselor. Hopefully he's an even better basketball player from what he's been telling me as he's shushing the crowd.
Yeah, that did not get a good reaction out of them. Another play running out now.
And our boys golf coach, Pete Sherman.
Coach Sherman running out now. And this is the most ruthless group of children I have ever seen in my life. They are booing these people.
Yeah, it's not something you'd see. I feel like we get booed. I feel like we get stopped. Like, the teachers tell us to stop booing the opposing team when we go to a varsity basketball game. But I guess the little kids can do it because it's only teachers.
I know, right? Well, the teachers aren't here to shut them up, right? They're all out on the court, so what are they going to do?
They can't do anything about it.
Now, I wonder if Sirico's going to introduce himself. This is what I'm
going to do. I don't know how this is going to happen. Mr. Summerlagen called out their business teacher in the high school.
Yeah. Here's another assistant principal. We saw Arvanite. Here's Fiorentino. He looks ready to go. I'm expecting big things. He's a sleeper pick to win MVP tonight.
Yeah, first year in the building for Mr. Fiorentino. You know, great to see that, you know, he's out playing in this game.
And Scarpula wearing the backwards hat, even out on the court. Love to see it.
Yeah, the shirt looks like it's about a rip, but, you know, he makes it work. Mighty gave him an XL. He's a big man.
He'll be a big force in the post down low tonight. Another gym teacher.
Coach Lindsay.
Coach Lindsay, we've seen her. Almost every student, I'm sure, has interacted with her. Hopefully she does some good things out there.
Coach O'Brien.
Yep. Coach O'Brien did not think he was going to play in this game. He was supposed to be traveling. Because the game was postponed, he's now playing. He tried to chest bump everyone. Mr. Moore chest bumps him.
Oh, this game's going to be so much fun.
It is. I don't know what to expect from Coach O'Brien. Maybe he has some skill.
She's an All-State softball player.
All-State softball player. DeSasso called out. Was an All-State softball player. Would never have guessed that. And now we are almost at the end of our team here.
Season in many years. He's an All-League basketball player.
Who is this being called? Oh, Coach Mackey.
Yeah.
Coach Mackey. Coach Mackey is making an appearance for the high school squad.
Coach Mackey has done an absolutely remarkable job with the boys basketball team. We've interviewed him, we've talked to him. He watches all our broadcasts now. We get to cover him. That'll be a fun one. Oh, and now the baseball coach, Eric Rosa, called out.
I gave him credit. That's the man who got me to start kicking. I have the voicemail.
Really?
My mom has the voicemail. He is the man who got me to start kicking, so I got to give him credit for that.
Wow, so we can't talk too much smack about it.
No, I can't.
Arvanite is going to be a baller tonight. You can tell. I mean, he just has the build for it, first of all. I am expecting big things from him.
He's a first-round draft pick. If this was a draft, which I might bring this idea up to Coach Sirico.
Okay.
I think this should be a draft 1 year. I think he might be one of the first picks. He might be a first-round pick or a starter, you could say, for the team
starter
if you're doing
sure.
it like the NBA. Yeah.
Now, absolutely incredible. We now have people sitting below the bleachers and standing around the edges because every seat in the gym has filled up.
Yeah, I don't know what the capacity limit in this gymnasium is.
Whatever it is, we have passed it today.
100%.
I can't even imagine how much money is going to be spent on concessions.
Yeah.
Something tells me Sirico's not going to
let us. I
don't
know if there's a half-court shot.
No way.
You were about to say that?
Sirico would be passing up way too much money there, all right? He is not going to let someone shoot that.
We have to get the kids on the camera.
That
must be a must tonight.
We've got Logan McKay running handheld camera for us here. He's been excited to do it, so I want to give him a shout out as he is doing it. A little shaky, though, Logan. You got to fix that by the end of the game.
It'll be all right. Yeah. Logan's a good cameraman.
He's learning. We see him, you know, behind the scenes. So many people behind the scenes. We're going to recognize them today.
Hopefully we can pan to the kids in the crowd right now.
Yep.
They're trying to get the camera love.
And it looks like we're going to play 4 10-minute quarters instead of 8-minute quarters. I think they're saying that these guys are more capable than the high school basketball teams because they're going to play a couple extra minutes, more basketball the better if you ask me. So out on the court to get a lay of the land. It looks like Coach Mackey's going to do the tip-off.
That's something you don't see.
Yeah. We got Rose out there.
Yeah, Mr. Panessi, a good sweat going. Coach Rose is out there as a starter. A little surprised by that.
And DeSasso, the final play. Oh, and Mackey wins the tip-off. And now Panessi has it. Gives it to Mackey. We're playing music during the game here. That's, you know, it's crazy. By Mackey pulls up. No good on the three, and it's rebounded. Here is the first attack for the middle schoolers.
Not surprised that was not surprised that Coach Mackey took the first shot of this game. He's probably going to take the most shots of any teacher in this game.
He's going to keep firing, and now we have O'Brien running the point center right here. Going to throw inside, and Rosa in the corner throws it away. Here's the attack from the middle school, and the layup is good. That's the first bucket of the night.
Big ovation for Coach Garcia there with the first points on the board. You know, great transition play. Let's see what the high school team can do.
Messi gets a screen from Rosa, finds O'Brien, back to Rosa. Ball movement, the drive, pull-up shot, and that one, unsurprisingly, does not fall. And attack the other way. Oh, and the screen, they wanted a foul call, didn't get it, and Myers drains the triple. 5-0 a minute into it.
I got to say, I thought that might have been a charge for Coach Panessi there. I thought he was robbed. I don't know who paid the refs, but I think someone definitely paid the refs.
DeSasso threw it too high. The ball almost attacked me and Drew there.
Yeah, I was up for that. I was ready.
How about the physicality? Teachers putting their bodies on the line for this one. The three is hit. I don't know. I missed
Astorino. It was Coach Astorino. Yeah.
Missed the angle with camera issues right now. We'll get those fixed as soon as possible for you. Now here's O'Brien. Oh, the Euro move. He gets to go. And O'Brien answers, and the high schoolers are on the board.
Yeah, big play by there. I think that's the varsity basketball connection between Mack and O'Brien. Something we're going to have to look at tonight.
And a response. Are you kidding me? The middle school team cannot miss right now.
I honestly think this is more fast-paced than the varsity games that we've done this year.
Oh, it absolutely is.
It has to be.
DeSasso throws it up. Good-looking shot. No good. Rebound, Garcia. And now, joining us on... Okay, never mind.
Miss Fox is not joining us.
Miss Fox sat down next to us. We thought she was going to join us on air. Maybe later. Maybe we'll talk her into it. Here's O'Brien with the ball.
I think Coach Mackey might be our first on-air guest. Oh, what a pass.
Oh, and Rosa couldn't handle it properly, but then he recovers and misses the layup. That was atrocious.
Very disappointing from Coach Rosa there. He'll hear that from me Monday morning, or Monday afternoon in gym class. Ninth period, he's going to get a word from me.
O'Brien grabs the board. We're 3 minutes into it, 11-2. Your middle and elementary school teachers leading this. There's a screen from Rosa. He's had a couple of those tonight. O'Brien with it. Oh, Mackey. Gotta get better with the hands there. I was gonna look for something. 30-footer is up and in. Are you kidding me, Coach Mackey? 5-11 the score now.
That was a big time three-pointer from Coach Mackey there. And Coach Putnam. Unlucky.
Can't answer. Heat check there. Does not fall. Coach Mack is a dead all-section basketball player. Led Warwick to one of their better seasons in recent history. Obviously, oh, and how about that? Get absolutely robbed by Putnam there. And the three is up. And gosh, are you kidding me? I've said it three times already, that exact phrase, because this game is just incredible right now.
Yeah, big lead for the middle school and elementary school teachers. Might have to be a timeout going to get called soon from Coach Arvanites, I would
Arvanites
think.
Arvanites needs to. They need to make some adjustments. There's the three, Rosa. No good rebound. And here come the middle school attack. Pass is going to go into the corner. Three is up and hit. 17-6 early. And this is a blowout so far.
I think this might get over 50 points.
Oh, it looks
we might
like
see more than 50 points tonight. But you can definitely tell that, you know, the pace of this game has kind of slowed down a little bit. No obvious reasons, but
Putnam can't get it to fall. DeSasso with the rebound. She loses it, but Rose is there to recover. They got a cross half court, and O'Brien does, throws it, and that one goes out of bounds. No, and we finally have substitutions, it looks like.
Oh, we're doing a full line change.
Yep, we got a lot of players getting involved. And what a start, an ovation for the middle school and elementary school teachers who just set the tone for the game here. 17-6.
Yeah, big first rotation, you can tell. A lot of the teachers coming for water over here.
Yeah, they're going to walk right by us to get to there. We're bringing a teacher on to enough Myers with the ball now. Going to give it to Coach Mann, modified basketball coach. Moving it around a lot.
See what Mr. Rauschenbach can do here.
Fires the three. Little short. Myers the rebound. Now Mann, long two. Another miss. And there's Tobin on the board. He's running. Gets it out. And how about Tobin asserting himself early in this one? He's going to pull up. He shoots. He hits backward. And the second look, no good as he falls.
Yeah, nothing is falling for this high school team right now. They're just chucking up shots.
Tobin told us if he airballed his first shot, he wouldn't shoot again. He hit backwards. We're going to see him play more in Rauschenbach. Second chance, no. Third chance, no. Another rebound. Three-pointer up. Myers off back rim, no good.
Someone's got to grab a rebound here.
Man shoots. Man scores. 19-6 with 4 minutes to play in this first quarter.
Yeah, big three from Coach Mann there. Coach Tobin, I don't know where he was. He was lost on that. Tried to play defense, but you know, Coach Mann got the better of him there.
How about this basketball game as Mr. Peters has it? Gives to Mann. They're not respecting her shot, and she is making them pay. Coach Mann, a second bucket early in this one.
Yeah, she's feeling it right now. Coach Tobin's trying to post up here.
She's getting active defensively, too. Here's the Candyman. The three is up. Oh, and that was ugly. He airballed that. Don't know if it was tipped or what, or if he just needs a brand new jumper. Back court violation is not called there behind the back pass of Mr. Peters.
I think that was a pass by Mr. Candia. I think he'll say that was a pass.
Oh, he'll say it, that's for sure. I don't know if I believe him. As Mann took a little heat check there. We've seen a lot of those early in this one. 21-6, though. The high schoolers are getting ran out of the gym right now. Three-pointer is up and missed. Rauschenbach the board. Starpula gonna pressure. It doesn't matter. Now Mann has it. Into Rauschenbach. Gets to go. You see our counters running now. Love to see it. And here's Sherman with the ball. Guarded by Mr. Peters, he's got height. Now Tobin in the post, over Rauschenbach. Oh, looked good, didn't get the roll, Tobin, 0-2 now.
Yeah, he's gonna, I've been trying to coach him up during lunch, trying to get him to get his shots up. He didn't want to do it, he wasn't committed, so.
Man,
in and out.
Get the roll, a lot of missed shots now in this stretch. Myers has it, goes back to Mann. Inside Rauschenbach, no defense, any game for layup. The gym is rocking right now. 23-6. 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Time for Arvanites and squad to go on a run. Candia now to Tobin. Three-pointer. Two. Strong Candia. The rebound. Oh, he missed it. Wide open. Five-footer. Couldn't fall. And now, middle school going to go on another offensive possession. Rauschenbach gets the mid-range jumper to fall. Drew, what is going on?
My MVP of the game, Mr. Rauschenbach, just got a big jumper there. He's going to win MVP tonight. I think Astorino might be the front runner right now.
Maybe, yeah. Coach Arvanites calls a much-needed timeout. His team's out of sync. This is one of the worst performances I've ever seen in this very gym.
Big ovation for the middle school.
Coach Rico told them to cheer, they cheered. The crowd's absolutely packed. This is insane.
Getting ready for the high school. If you think the high school's gonna come back, let me hear it.
And the high school's getting booed.
Oh, yeah.
This is nuts.
Very disappointing there's no high schoolers here.
Yeah.
I guess everyone else has better stuff to do on a Friday night.
Yeah, not me and Drew, though. We have nowhere we would rather be right now. Dr. Leach at the game. He promised us he'd come on air at some point. We're going to hold him to that. We can't take much action against the superintendent of the schools if he lies to us, but we hope he shows up because it would be fun.
Yeah, I was talking to him pregame, trying to see if he would, maybe let in a little something, and he said, maybe halftime, a surprise might come, and he might suit up because the high school team might need it.
Yeah. There's a shot missed by Sharpua, and Vanderstar, quick hands to grab the board. Gets it to Sharpua. His first appearance in this one. Now, Pandya, another three. That one was definitely not a pass, and that one was definitely not a make.
I think we should maybe get Mr. Astorino here.
Oh!
To come on.
No way! That
I didn't see what just happened.
The Candyman stuffed Rauschenbach, and that was the play of the game right there.
I didn't even see it. Is the headset on for Mr. Astorino?
I hear you guys. I hear you guys loud.
Yeah. So, joining us now on the call, Mr. Astorino, middle school star of the PM.
What's going on, Drew? What's going on, Teddy? It's a pleasure to be here. The comm program has evolved so much in the past 10 years. Having this kind of setup for the Ultamania game is amazing. I love what you guys
do. We're having so much fun with this. We're also having fun watching you play out there. What's been the story for you tonight?
I didn't know I could shoot. I was like, all right, I'm going to go out there and have fun, put on a show for all the kids. And the good guys are up big early, so we're hoping to keep it that way, okay?
Yeah, me and Drew are hoping for a competitive game. Watching from the high school's perspective, what would you say they should do to get back in this game?
They need size. They just aren't big enough.
Now, O'Brien's got to get back out there, I'd say. He's taking
he's already exhausted. He needs to rest up. But maybe we'll see him out there in the second quarter.
The only thing I think you guys have an advantage is I think the water table is behind us.
Yeah,
so I don't think the high school teachers know that.
Right, we got to tell them because we want to see a fun game here.
That's big. Thank you so much, guys, for having me.
It's been a pleasure having you on.
Thank you.
Love hearing from the teachers, and that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter, that interview there with Mr. Astorino. We'll see if him and his middle school and elementary school squad can keep his team dominating. 25-12 right now. It's a blowout at the end of one.
Nature is a beautiful thing, but us humans have been ruining our planet. It is safe to say that without trees, humans would not be alive. Deforestation is a problem all over the world, and we need to find an alternative method. We need help. New York State Forest Action Plan is planning on restoring our forests. This organization is planning on completing their plan in 10 years. Do your part by helping stop deforestation. Visit dec.ny.gov today.
And we are back, folks, for this second quarter action here, the Ultimania game. The middle school and elementary school squad is up 25-12 at the start of this second quarter. And we have Coach Tobin about to join us here at the table. Tobin first, then Mr. Candia will join us.
All right, we are back. Second quarter of action, and special guest, Coach Tobin joining us. Coach, you gotta lower your headset if you want.
I can't hear you.
Yeah.
You can't hear me at all?
Now we can go. There we go.
I'm all discombobulated because I'm the worst basketball player in this place.
I can't even argue with that statement after what I saw from you out there.
I was saying on the broadcast how I was trying to get you going during lunch, trying to support you here, trying to get you going with the shots, but I said you didn't want to do it. You weren't committed.
I took shots before you got in there, but clearly nothing
happened. About
all right, we needed that.
Fiorentino.
Big points.
Wow. So now 9-point game. Mr. Coleman, what do you say your team needs to do to get back in this game?
Well, first and foremost, I think we need to put some points on the board. I think that would help.
Yeah.
And not leave three-point shooters wide open.
Yeah.
I'm not a basketball guy, but, it seems pretty simple.
Yeah, I mean, Coach Mann from the middle school team is making you guys pay right now. She's like 6 points.
I think she hit two in my face.
Yeah,
honestly.
She did. You need to improve.
I mentioned that. Don't worry. Yeah, that's on the broadcast.
All right. Are you going to score tonight?
I think I'm 0-3, so I might not take another shot.
I want to see you keep shooting. Me and Drew,
honestly, if this game keeps going the way it is, why not? Why not just go for it?
Keep going up. We want to see you put points on the board. And it's great talking to you. Go out there and go win this game for the high school team. We want to see that happen, all right?
Appreciate it, guys.
Yeah, pleasure having you on.
Thank you.
Go Rangers.
Yeah, go Rangers. Drew, we're going to be doing the NHL show at the school, little up. Coach Drew. Forget hockey, Coach Drew, bringing back wrestling, gets the ball, blows away. That's the wrestling experience right there. Does everything except make the shot.
And the Candyman has joined us.
Yes, the Candyman
The Candyman is here.
Fellas, my line almost got shut out. If not for Global Studies 2 superstar John Vanderstar, we don't score. A lot of fun out there. I think our defense was a mess. I was yelling, play man, people were just guarding whoever, but a lot of fun out there. This middle school squad is really talented. I mean, Brad Garsha popping those two threes in the first quarter, it's a lot of fun out there, though. I'm enjoying it.
Coach Zoom pops a three off count. That one's so good.
Close shot.
Okay, so, Ryan, we and Andrew were talking pregame. Is there any animosity between these two over Drew taking it down?
You know, it's year after year, everybody says, like, the middle school's going to win, they never win. I'll admit, they got the better talent. We're old. Jim O'Brien, 10, 15 years ago, takes over the game. It becomes O'Brien versus Rauschenbach. Rauschenbach still got it. He's a great athlete. He's very humble about it. But it's, you know, it's all fun. You get everybody in. And, you know, we're just here to raise money for a good cause and play some ball.
Yeah, certainly.
That's, I don't know how much ball is being played, but, you know.
Yeah.
Well, Brad Garsha looks like on Fuego. Kyle Putnam came out firing. Joe Astorino, who doesn't have a good shot, nailed a three. Good job, Joe.
He told us he didn't think he was able to shoot.
Yeah,
like
that's
that.
What I do, yeah.
He was our first guest before Coach Tobin.
Nice, nice. Well, it's an honor being a guest.
Well,
with the best broadcasting team this side of the Hudson Valley, I might say.
Yeah, I'd say both sides of Hudson Valley. You will not find a group better than us. And it was great having you on to broadcast with us, the three of us. We brought you basketball coverage all year. Now go out there and score for this team, okay? Don't airball another three.
Thanks, guys. See ya.
Thank you, Mr. Candia.
Gotta love the dodging of the tough question there. Just completely ignored what me and Drew asked him. But it's always great having the Candyman on. I'm surprised he didn't start singing on the broadcast like he usually does. Let's get back to the action. We've had a bunch of guests. 16-25 in the score. Our high school team's closed the gap a little bit.
I don't think anyone notices, but the high school team has six people on the court right now.
No way.
There are six high school people on the court right now.
First of all, Coach Zoom, incredible shot hit. But
yeah, I don't think anyone notices that.
Six players are indeed on the court.
Coach Zoom getting shouted out here. Couldn't hear what it exactly was. And now we have someone coming off.
He's back out there now. He went to the sideline. Now he's back on the court.
I guess the high school is just doing that bad that there's that they're allowing them to go with six people, but.
How about Fiorentino? He's running around everywhere. He's making an impact on this game. Now Coach Zoom has it. And he got fouled.
Foul called, wow. Coach Lindsay with the getting foul called there.
Yeah, come on, swallow the whistle there, ref. We're going to heckle the refs here tonight. We're usually very respectful.
Yeah.
But come on, let him play. Our shot is up and missed. And Fiorentino hits the deck. Grabs the ball. He was fouled. How about that play?
Coach McGilroy with the little push after the rebound. Getting called for the foul. But
Fiorentino puts it down, starts dancing. How about that? I don't know what we just witnessed, but I love it. Coach defensively. And now Lindsay getting mobbed, dumps it off. Drew is silenced by what he just saw.
Yeah, this is hilarious.
This is probably the most fun I've had calling a game. Now DeSasso's going to fire a three. Good looking shot, missed. And the rebound is fought for and secured by, I believe this is Mr. White, our custodian. Now Fiorentino, pump fake, got him to bite. Floater is up, floater is good. Fiorentino making an impact on this one.
Big, nice little pump fake from Mr. Fiorentino there. Kind of surprised how well he's playing right now.
Yeah, I said I thought he had sleeper potential pregame, and he's shown that. Helping to mount this comeback. It's now an 8-point game. Get close as it's been in a while. There's the steal. And the spin move, he lost it, though. That would have been nuts. He pulled it off, and now the high schoolers have it back. DeSasso was fouled. There's a blocking foul going against, I believe, Miss Beck. And with 4 minutes to play in the half, we have some subs coming in.
Yeah, I don't know if this you call this the A lineup for this high school squad.
Well, the B lineup played better than the A lineup then.
I think the C lineup might have played better than both the A and the
yeah.
B.
So let's see. Out of the court, we have Vanderstar.
I think we have some trash talking going on between Mr. O'Brien and Mr. Rauschenbach.
We'll always love to see that. And who's going to inbound the ball? Oh, it's going to be Vanderstar inbounding. That was a bad inbound pass. And what just happened?
Easy buckets for the high school team.
Did the middle schoolers forgot what basket they were scoring on?
They're back in this game, though.
Well, what did we just see? That was absurd. That happened in the NBA a couple nights ago with the Dallas Mavericks.
I remember seeing that.
Yeah. It was. That's just zero awareness. That's horrible coaching by Radon. You got to tell your squad what they're doing.
Yeah, that's something he might get upset about.
Yeah. Now O'Brien has it. Pops a triple. Overman, no good. And Rosa tried to clean up the miss.
Another miss from Coach Rosa.
Oh, didn't do it, yeah.
Make sure I bring that up to him. Very disappointed.
I'd say Rosa, without a doubt, has been the worst player out on the court here tonight.
Honestly, it's the baseball coaches. Tobin, yeah. Rosa, Mr. Panessi's not really doing anything. Mr. Vanderstar. Astorino, the modified baseball coach, is the best one.
Yeah. So now O'Brien has it. 3 minutes to play. Is he going to throw up another three? No, he's going to pass out. And that was the worst shot of the night from Tobin. And Scott Myers has it now. And the middle school is going to run. Here's Mr. Peters to Myers. Three-pointer is up. No good. And the ball goes out of bounds. High school ball.
Yeah, Mr. Tobin took that shot, and he directly looked at me right after.
Yeah.
And he was shocked. Careless pass there by Mr. Sherman.
Yeah, that was bad. And we heard him on camera. Mindy Osarina gives to Mann. Coach Mann slows things down. Quiet second quarter after dominating early on. Three-pointer is up, airballed. And a bit of a scoring drought here for the middle schoolers. As Coach Sirico just announced, 2 minutes to play in the half. There's a steal by Myers. He's going to run the fast break for his squad. Guarded up by Vanderstar. This is a fun matchup. Vanderstar knocks away. Mr. Peters recovers. Now Fox pulls up and no good. Rebound Rosa.
Yeah, Coach Sirico just mentioned that the Cupid Shuffle is happening at halftime. He needs high schoolers to help. That is something me and Theodore will not be a part of.
Oh, really?
I'm hoping we're not a part of that.
Something tells me our director, Shane Crane, will be a part of that.
100%. I think Crane will make an appearance.
He better. I'll be disappointed. That's
the rumor I heard.
I think I want to see you make an appearance, though.
No, I don't dance. No. I'm retired.
Me and Drew have a bad track record of halftime festivities here.
Yes.
We both airballed half-court shots at, after our broadcast, and never again, right? That was an embarrassing moment. You go up in front of all those people and you airball. And Tobin can't get that one to fall. We're down to 120 to play. Still a 6-point game. 1 minute away. Now Peters has it inside. The shot is up. Bit of a line drive. No good. And Sherman secures it.
Yeah, Mr. Sherman has a couple of rebounds for this high school squad tonight.
Well, he's big. He's a big player out there. And there's a miss. O'Brien, speaking of big men, grabs it. And bit of a tie up here. No, did they call a foul? It's a tie.
Oh, they're calling high school.
Okay. I wanted to see a jump ball. That's what I was hoping for.
Coach Rosa trying to play quickly right now.
Yeah, he wants to take advantage. They pause the clock for this. Oh, and Sherman was wide open in the corner. They should have passed it to him. Now Astorino has the ball. Now he's going to run it. Ball knocked away. 46 seconds to play in the half. Here's Mann with the basketball.
There's seven people on the court for this. I guess they're just not counting with the people. Hey, you know what? It's all good.
Well, I don't think we have any math teachers out on the court, so that would explain it. But yeah, you're right. This is way over five, that's for sure.
Yeah.
And I have 26 seconds to play. Rosa with it. Pass to Sasso inside. There's the give to O'Brien, who gets fouled hard in the paint. And we have our first free throws of the night coming up.
Yeah, it's a big matchup. Mr. O'Brien and Mr. Rauschenbach. Two big guys going at it.
Misses the free throw. Now, if you're a girls basketball player and you miss a free throw, you know O'Brien's going to start screaming at you.
Oh, 100%.
So I think someone should start yelling at him right now.
All right, one for two. We'll give him that.
Yeah, that's respectable.
Mr. Sumlin with a nice little gesture there, giving the ball back. If I was him, I think I would have let that roll.
I might have kicked it the other way.
Yeah.
So now 10 seconds. This is going to be the last shot of the half. Man pops it. Can't get it to fall. And now Sherman has it. Throw up a full court shot. Let's see it. It's up. Oh, that off the angle. Looked like it had a shot. That'll do it. 27-22. We have ourselves a ball game here in Warwick. Halftime, Cupid shuffle happening. They're mopping the floor. They're going to have some fun, and we're going to have some fun in the second half of action coming up next.
An endangered species is a type of organism that is threatened by extinction. The number of endangered animal species is increasing every day. The largest cause of endangerment is almost always created by human activities. Healthy ecosystems depend on these animal species, and we as humans rely on strong ecosystems to sustain our environment and life. We need to protect these rare species at all costs. WWF works to conserve endangered species and protect endangered spaces.
And we are back after probably the longest halftime I've ever seen. They were doing the Cupid Shuffle, they were doing the Cotton Eye Joe, they were doing the Macarena, they were doing every dance in the book. Shane Crane, our director, was out there as promised. And this is without a doubt one of the craziest events I've seen in this gym. They ran out of concessions.
Yeah.
Yeah. Camera off Brooke Pulse Hour. She went to go get like a soda or something. She said they were completely out.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
But you know, it's great to see so many people out supporting our teachers that do so much for us as students, and just shows how
you guys can see the elementary schoolers like lined up sitting center court now. That's awesome.
All the signs that are made and stuff.
Yeah, people are into it. This is one of the coolest events I've seen at this gym. And with that being said, we're ready to bring you coverage of the second half. As far as on the court, you know, obviously it's not about the basketball, but what have you seen out of the basketball team play?
Very physical. Didn't think it was going to be this physical, you know. I think someone said Coach Sherman got elbowed in the face.
Wow.
Coach told me, you know, trying to box out a little bit, getting into it with people. The O'Brien and Rauschenbach rivalry, you could say, is going. So, you know, it's great to see. You know, it's very competitive. You know, these teachers definitely take it seriously. They want to win. They want the bragging rights. They want to show off for these kids. So, it's been great.
Yeah, you know, we talked to a couple of the teachers. First of all, most of them are gassed. Like, the stamina on these teachers, not great. They got to work that out a little.
Yeah, you know, I didn't think in the off season they were prepared. Yeah. They had probably a 3 or 4 year layover from the last game. So,
right.
I guess they didn't take this too seriously.
We saw Vanderstar like outside, huffing and puffing, hands on his knees. Yeah, maybe he'll go with Lee on his kids at football practice going forward. We also saw Vanderstar in particular. He told me that he's feeling it out there. He's made his only shot he's taken, but he's been focused a little too much on passing. He says it's time for him to get a little more selfish. We'll see if he can do that. Who else did we talk to? Tobin, who's 0 for 4.
Yeah, Tobin's 0 for 4.
The Tobinators, got to get things
He said shooter shoot, so I guess he's considering himself a shooter.
Oh, yeah. I don't know about that.
Which is interesting to see.
Mackey with the ball in the corner. How did that pass? That was horrible. That is why he is no longer playing. And the layup blown now, and Parsha secures it.
And
O'Brien heavily in pursuit.
Mr. Garsha, big rebound there.
Some action underneath. Mackey trying to get a hand on the ball. O'Brien the trap and forces the turnover.
That's a good stop for the high school.
Okay, so now they're going to get back into it. Wow. Three is hit. How about that one? Coach still has some game in him.
Great season for his. Oh, big crossover by Garsha.
And he can't answer himself, but he gets it back. Thought about popping again instead. They're going to move the rock around a little. The Blizzard is punting him with the ball, right? Who shoots? No good. Now, some more ball movement. And the high schoolers just can't grab a rebound. They finally secure one, and Arvanite's making his a first appearance in this one.
I love the fundamental rebounding there from Mr. Arvanite. You know, gets it, puts it to the chin, moves around with it, makes sure he's good. Love that from him.
Nothing fundamental about that last shot by Mackey as he tried to throw it over the backboard. And
it was
get
a trick shot. It was a trick shot.
You like to see it, yeah. Remember when the Harlem Wizards, it wasn't the Globetrotters, it was the Wizards who would come to town. As the ball goes after us, and we throw it into Arvanites. I want to see Auburn Knights get involved in the post. That's what I'd say.
Yeah, definitely. You know, I'm kind of feeling it right now. But high school trying to use the size that they have. But it hasn't been working out in this game so far.
Now we're going to have a guest appearance on our headset. And we, in a minute, we'll get to you in a minute. We have a guest lined up, ready to come on. Right now, we've seen a bit of a stoppage in play. The ref's going to set it up. Give it to, is that Putnam to inbound? And a lot of pressure on this inbound. They're having trouble getting it to anyone, or Sherman, rather, that is, the high schooler. And now some more action. Mackey with the ball. And how about that? We have a foul before anything happens. Sorry for the bit of hiccup in calling it there. But now we're going to get to our guest. So we're joined right now by 8th grade Warwick basketball star Jake Costa. Jake, can you hear me? Yeah?
Yeah.
We got to get him unmuted. Here we go.
All right.
Yeah, welcome to Warwick Valley Television. We're really glad to have you on air.
Uh-huh.
You, I'll talk about your basketball career a little. 8th grader, you played on JV this past season. How was that?
It was a great experience, you know, playing with a bunch of older guys. You know, I really loved it. Great environment to be around.
Yeah, you know, look, you're coming in as one of the future stars of Warwick basketball. What have you seen from the team like this year, having watched all their games?
You know, I saw a lot of potential in us, the way we pass the ball and shoot it, and I saw a lot of just, like, strive to be great. That's what I like to see.
Yeah, and what do you envision, like, where do you envision your role in this? Like, what's your ultimate goal playing with Warwick basketball?
It's to become the best player I could possibly become, you know. Maybe try to play in college is my goal.
Yeah, that's what we love to hear. Now, back to the game on the court. What did you see tonight? What's your take on the basketball being played?
You know, I think it's been a good game so far. I like to see Coach Mack do a little bit more, though, off the bench, Coach McElroy. You know, guys can do a little more. But Tom Kelly overall, he's playing great, I think. Mr. Putnam, you know, he's playing great. It has been a great game so far. You just got to stop Mackey.
Now, we're in the second half. We're getting to the end of this game. If you had to declare an MVP from the action out here, who would your pick be?
Oh, Mr. Putnam for sure. You know, he started the game off in a bunch of threes, you know.
Big choice.
We got some momentum, yeah. A lot of momentum for the middle school elementary school team.
Yeah, I respect it. All right, well, Jake, it's been a pleasure having you on. Looking forward to hearing about your actions out on the court. Thanks for coming and joining us, sir.
Hey, no problem. See you guys
Thank
later.
You so much.
Have a good one, Jake.
No problem.
So while that was going on, the high school team takes their first lead of the game. It's 28-27 as Jake walks away. So this one's going to go right down to the wire as far as the actual basketball goes, I'd say, halfway through this third quarter.
Yeah, definitely. You know, big competitive, not a lot of scoring in this third quarter.
Yeah, you know, defense really settling in. Also, they're getting tired. Also, we have shots like that going up. Coach Rosa
hit the rim. You got to give him,
yeah,
gotta give him credit when credit's
ball.
Due. Oh, what a pass.
And how about that? Back on top, back and forth they go. It's now 29-28 and a timeout as Mackey threw up the half-court shot for fun. So we're right at the halfway mark of the third quarter now. They're all gathered out. We had a timeout called by the high school team. While this is going on, you know, University of Alabama, the Crimson Tide are in a battle with San Diego State. This is live, so by the time y'all see this, the result will be live. But we're having fun watching, following this game. University of Alabama, a future school for me. And Miami is also on top of Houston. I'm a big March Madness fan, Drew, and I've had fun following this game.
Yeah, I watched a couple games. My bracket is busted, just like everyone else in this country.
Well,
but
who is your pick?
I had Purdue winning and Duke winning, which obviously that
so
didn't work out well.
You know, Purdue losing to FDU, fairly Dickinson. Absolutely insane. That's a school from the area. They're only 45 minutes away. It was cool seeing them win.
Yeah, great to see them. And, you know, their head coach moved on to Iona. Big job for him. See what he can do next year as first-year head coach.
Yeah, basketball in the area, both here in New York and Jersey as well, is really taking off. And also, you got to look at the local basketball. We got some local players, Kyle Filipowski. I forget his name, Tennessee, one of their better players. They just got eliminated, but he's from Hyde Park. So there are a lot of ballers in the area making an impact on the national level.
Yeah, great to see so many great guys from the local area making it in such a big stage.
Okay, so back to the game at hand. Vander Sarda inbound. He calls himself a pass and delivers a strike there. Now contested, avoided the backcourt violation, but still turned over nonetheless. Myers throws a lob, and Mr. Peters couldn't finish. That would have been a big-time moment.
Yeah, Coach Bauer almost with the layup attempt from...
Oh, Tobin couldn't secure the rebound. He had a chance to put up, put back, and now here's man running, runs out of steam, settles for the jumper, and missed it. Peters with the board. And now Tobin with the steal. Tobin runs it, Tobin throws it away, and now joining us on the broadcast in a minute, we have the one and only Coach Mackey. Coach, Coach, how are you doing tonight?
Oh, fellas, it's good to be here. It's good to be on the other side for
good
the first time.
Good to have you on. You know, we've covered your team extensively this season. Good to talk to you on camera right now. How have you felt out there playing tonight?
Oh, I mean, it's hot in here. There's a ton of people.
Yeah.
Only playing 5 minutes every, like, hour is not good for the body, but that's all right.
Coach, now, I don't want to sound a little critical here, but this is a bigger crowd than I've ever seen at one of your games. What do we need to do to get this kind of people at your boys' basketball games?
I don't know. Maybe Cotton Eye Joe at halftime or something.
Cotton Eye Joe at halftime?
I don't know.
I think it might be the Cupid Shuffle at halftime.
Cupid
I think
Shuffle,
that's the draw.
What it is. Yeah.
I think that's what's getting all the kids here.
You know, they ran out of concessions tonight. Like, by halftime, they were out. It was absolutely absurd.
I love it. It's a great fundraiser. I think it's like $7 to enter, so can't beat it. I wish the high school was putting up a better performance. I think those numbers might be a little inflated on our side, but that's all right.
Now, I don't know what's been going on, because when you're not there to coach and Hawkeye's coaching, me and Drew, we've seen like seven players out at a time for your team. What's going on there?
Well, Coach Sirico does what he always does. He says we don't have enough people, so everybody's got to show up.
Okay.
So now we have 35 on our roster, so we're trying to get seven in every rotation. So it's definitely difficult, but... Listen, we're going to do anything we have to do to win. I mean, we're being booed in our own gym, which is okay. It's a playoff atmosphere. That's all.
It is. Speaking of playoffs, you guys won your first playoff game in a couple years. How do you feel about your boys' squad going forward?
I mean, I talked to a few people today. It takes about a month to get over the season ending. So I think we lost on March 1st or 2nd. So we're almost at a month. And, you know, it's bittersweet because we feel like for the first time in my tenure, we felt like we could have won the section championship.
Yeah.
We've had good teams in the past, but this year we felt like we had the best team. And then to be up two with 20 seconds to go against Middletown and, you know, lose in overtime hurt. I mean, it was a great year overall. It's our first playoff win since 2007.
Yep.
It's the highest playoff seed we've ever had. So a lot of good takeaways, but we were a little, we're still a little upset because we felt like we could have won it, especially because Newberg beat us by 3 points twice, so we knew if we played them again, I think we would have beat them, but can't play that game now.
Yeah. Well, we just talked to Jay Costco on this broadcast, eighth grader. He seems very excited about playing for your program, and we're really looking forward to seeing what – well, me and Drew will be here, but we'll certainly be following what you and your team does in the future.
Yeah. I mean, I think the biggest takeaway from this year is that the community, the younger groups, are starting to believe that we belong in AA, and we have a good JV group coming up, a good modified group coming up. Our rec program is awesome. So hopefully the community will continue to believe that we belong here. And I think with a good offseason, we'll be ready for next year as well.
All right, well, it's been great having you on. Great talking basketball with you. Go on there and win the game for the high school.
Yeah, I'm going to go stretch for 20 minutes, hydrate, and I'll be ready. Thanks, fellas.
Thank you, Coach. Have a great one. Always love talking to Coach Mack. Absolutely incredible what he's done with the boys basketball program. And while he's gone, the middle school has extended their lead to 3 points. Now Vanderstar going to pop a three. Vandy a little short on that one, and the middle school is going to take it the other way.
Yeah, Coach Sirico brought it up during the Cupid Shuffle extravaganza at halftime that it is Mr. Vanderstar's birthday, so great to see him out here playing in this great cause on his own birthday, which is great to see.
Oh, and how about that response? You know, Vanderstar, it may be his birthday, does not mean he'll be celebrating. You know, looks like this middle school team has other ideas. Now here is Scarpula. Haven't seen him do much today. We're looking for him to break out. How about that pass to Tobin, who throws it up? That was the best looking shot he's taken all night, I'll tell you that.
Oh, 0 for 7, I think Tobin is?
Yeah.
Wow. call himself a shooter. Doesn't look like that much of a shooter tonight.
You miss 100% of shots you don't take, but if you're Tobin, you also miss 100% of the shots you do take. He's got to get something figured out with this jumper.
Yeah, maybe get the post game working, but that wasn't working for him too, so I don't know what's going to work for him tonight.
Here's Peters in the corner. Three-pointer is up. No good. I believe he teaches my brother in something, Mr. Peters, that is. I don't know, my brother in eighth grade, classmate Jake Costco, we spoke to. He gave me a scouting report on a couple of the teachers, my brother Peter. He's crewed for us. And now back to the action, we see Scarpula. That was just bad communication. No look pass, though, and it leads to almost a turnover. Drew, I think there's one resounding question from this game. Where is Mr. Warren?
Yeah, Mr. Orvenites brought it up the pregame that he was going to be the player to watch, but he's been non-existent for this high school team.
Yeah, we need to see him out there. He promised me that he'd cross up three defenders for me tonight. He hasn't gotten the opportunity.
Yeah, that was the talk of today during school. I mean, everyone was talking about Mr. Warren, first appearance playing, a graduate of Warwick Valley High School a couple years ago. But he hasn't shown up tonight.
We
really
all want him
to
out
see.
There. Now Vanderstar pumping, looking for someone, finds Tobin, another try, another miss.
Another miss for Mr. Tobin.
Now
very
2 seconds to go. Mr. Peter to the hole, puts it up, can't beat the buzzer. And with 10 minutes of basketball to go, 34-28, the middle school and elementary school teachers are one period away from securing the victory. Theodore Fernandez, Drew Borner, we'll be right back with the fourth and final quarter.
5 million gallons of waste are dumped into the ocean yearly, damaging the environment. 1 million marine animals die yearly from sea pollution, and 8 million tons of plastics enter our oceans every year. Sea pollution doesn't only affect sea animals, it affects us humans as well. Clear Blue Sea is a nonprofit organization that helps fight pollution. They use AI-controlled boats with nets to collect trash. If you want to get involved today, you can.
Here we go, fourth quarter, missed the first couple seconds there, but we are ready to bring you coverage of this final period, and Coach Zoom
splashes a three. It's big three-pointer.
It's now a nine-point game. Wow. Coach Zoom, you know, the wrestler is transplanting his skills to the hardwood, and that was just incredible. Now Candia needs an answer, long to his post on the line, but he trains it nonetheless. And they're going to give him credit for the three. Actually, they just gave 4 points for that try. Much needed booster for the team. And
what a pass.
Down there.
Mr. Radon with the great pass.
Okay, so now they're getting back to it. We have an interview subject ready in a minute once we can get a camera on him. We'll bring you that momentarily. And there's the shot that goes out of bounds. So 1 minute into this quarter. And the
Coach Sirico's in the game.
Coach, really? Yes, he is. You're right. I completely missed that. And they're going to feed it to him down low. And he had it almost knocked away, lost it out of bounds. So now we have a special guest on, Ryan Aronoff. Ryan in the studio production class. How are you doing tonight, Ryan?
Oh, I'm doing great. How are you, man?
We're doing absolutely incredible. We're having so much fun broadcasting this. Now, Ryan, there's a reason we brought you on. Because this is a basketball game, and you're not a sports fan.
No, not really.
So much about this game is about the non-sports aspect. What have you seen just from the atmosphere of that?
Well, I feel like I should be obligated to root for the high school team, but I'm kind of looking at the middle school team, especially because of Coach Zoom and Mr. Kelly. They're both like my favorite teachers that I've had, so I think I'm going to stick with that. I think every year that I've been here, I've been rooting for Mr. Kelly every single time.
Coach Zoom's kind of been balling tonight.
Coach Zoom.
Balling. He's been hitting from threes.
Yeah. Except the high school team is surprising me. Like vice principal, Mr. Fiorentino, dude, he's doing really well.
Well, yeah. What was your takeaway on the dance he did? How do you feel about that?
I mean, dude, I had no idea that the guy was a baller. And when he put down the ball and started doing a celebration before he even had to celebrate anything, it's iconic, honestly.
You respect that, you're a fan.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
All right, what's your prediction for this game going the rest of the way? What do you think's going to happen?
I feel like high school might take it.
You think they're going to get a comeback?
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
I'm getting so excited watching Coach Sirico. Big three, and then a box out, then a block on Coach Zoom. I'm getting so excited watching him play.
Yeah, Ryan, we're going to
kick. He's running point guard right now.
Yeah, we're going to kick you out now, Ryan. Thank you for coming on.
Yeah, of course, man.
Pleasure talking with you. Me and Drew, we
Thanks,
have
sir.
7.5 minutes. We're going to bring
you
the rest of this game. Have a good one,
Ryan. Have a good one, guys.
Yep. Okay, so 5-point game. Love hearing from Ryan there.
And now, this is a very winnable game for the high schoolers with Coach Sirico out there. How about that? They're all behind the back pass to Zoom, who blew the layup. And now he gets the miss, misses again. Coach Zoom ruined what would have been an all-time Ultamania highlight right there by missing the layup. Now Sirico has it.
Coach Sirico should have played the whole entire game.
He should have. Saved
first
himself.
Shot he takes with a big three-pointer.
Candyman almost falls. Now, oh, that was his turnover. Right to the hands of Zoom. Now the throw for Putnam. Another no-look pass.
Wow.
And this time they drain it. How about that?
This is amazing.
Now, Candy, a three-pointer. It's up. That was a decent-looking shot. He got his own miss. Now Sirico. Coach Sirico gets it back to Candy. It's left open again. They don't respect him. Is he going to make him pay? No, he throws a bad pass. Back to Candia. Now Sirico in the corner. Throw. The shot. No good on the three. They needed that one. 6 minutes to go. It's a seven-point game. Okay. So now, throw inside Mr. Putnam, and Coach Zoom has it. Ball movement. Shot is up and missed. And now the high school is going to try to settle, but no, it's a steal. Three-pointer is up and green. That might have been the dagger. It's now a 10-point ball game with 5.5 minutes to play.
Yeah, maybe Coach Sirico might be calling a timeout here. Maybe something going on.
He said something to the ref, and now they're going. Coach Sirico going to try a three, and he got
it.
Wow.
Big three-pointer from Coach Sirico there. But this middle school squad that was just on the court of Mr. Radon, Mr. Potter, and Coach Zoom, the connection, the chemistry you could say between the three of them was amazing. But no-look passes, they must have been practicing in the middle school last week.
Yeah, and they look more prepared out there, and they've just been absolutely balling. I mean, to be up seven on this, let's face it, much more talented high school team, this is absolutely incredible. Upset for the ages. If I'm not mistaken, it looks like we're about to have a full court press by the high schoolers. I could not imagine what this is going to look like as they force a turnover right away. Arvinites with the rock. O'Brien, Mackey. This is the A squad out there for the high schoolers, and that's a missed layup by Arvinites. Ryan Candia is going to join us on the call here. Mr. Candia, you missed a couple threes out there. What happened? Well, Mr. Candia is actually muted right now. He's got to get the audio.
Yeah, Mr. Candia is muted.
Oh,
wait a second.
Here we go. What happened there?
What happened? I drained a three, man.
You drained a three?
He won.
Sirico. We had good chemistry out there. Now, we're still losing by 7 points, but it was a lot of fun.
Is Coach Sirico still out there? No, he's not.
No. He drained two threes, man. Yeah. We had like nice chemistry going. Old man Sunday basketball. So.
We need him back out on the court.
We should give him a set right now.
Coach, we need you out here. We need you out here, Coach.
Get the headset on. Here's Coach. Hand off.
Yeah.
Hand off. Coach, you're on the set. Bye, guys.
Come on, Coach.
Yeah. Coach, you're on the set. In a minute.
Gotta take water. Gotta get water.
This is a crazy moment. Okay, give him the headset. Okay, Coach Sirico on air. Coach, how's it going?
Hey, it's going good. We're down a little bit, but we're battling. I really think we got a shot at the end with Coach Mackey out there and Coach O'Brien. And we're just one three ball away from making this a ball game.
Coach, why aren't you out there right now?
55 years old, boys. I'm hanging in there.
You hit two
threes.
I'm just
trying to hang out with you young guys.
Yeah. Okay.
Two big three-pointers.
There's a lot of fouling going on out there. That's pretty physical.
There is. I was shocked by it. Teachers putting their bodies on the line. What happens if someone gets hurt today, Coach?
Yeah, no, a lot of fun, guys. Thanks for covering this. And I got a feeling Coach Rose is going to hit a three, put us right back in.
Coach Rose hitting a three. We hope so. Thanks for joining us,
boys.
Thank you, Coach.
Go out there and win. Coach Rose is draining a three. Is not on my checklist. Coach Sirico pointed to the camera, didn't realize it wasn't on program.
No.
That would have been a cool shot. Well, it's not a Sirico moment without the camera point, you know?
100%.
Yeah. So, three-point game. He seems amped up. His team's right in it. But the middle schoolers are playing very, very well. There's the miss. And the ball's going to go. It's going to stay on this end, actually. Wasn't sure what the call was going to be. Down the inbound. The shot, O'Brien's defense wasn't enough. Back up to a 5-point game. Now Sherman going to take it. Going to throw to O'Brien. Inside. Arvanites. Layup. No good. Gets it on miss. Another one. Still has the ball.
Finally, and a foul was called.
Yeah. Coach Rico was talking about the physicality. They finally blow a whistle. And Arvanites are going to earn two at the free throw line. We are officially under 2.5 minutes to play. This is crunch time right now. First free throw. Oh, he's not built for the moment. He misses that one. I might get in school suspension for what I say. I don't care. You shoot a free throw like that, you deserve to be called out.
If me and Theodore are not in school on Monday, we are in school, but in school detention.
Yeah. I don't know how long they punish it for. There's another miss, and I'm not even going to say what I was planning on saying because it would have been a little too far. Now, here is the middle school attack. Inside, feed. And Rosa's defense forces the miss. Another shot is missed, and O'Brien secures the board. 2 minute mark in the game, 47-42 your score. Now O'Brien to the hole, puts it up, no good, gets the miss. Another one, no good. And now Sherman. Now Rosa three-pointer. Oh,
let's go!
Rico called it. He said Rosa would hit
let's
a three.
Go.
Rosa hit a three. And it's a two-point ball game, closest as it's been since the first quarter.
All right, now I won't talk trash to him in gym class.
Yeah, he's earned it. Now, this is going to be an incredible finish in the mind.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're running down. We just want to thank everyone for coming out tonight.
Coach Rico giving a shout out to the fans.
They're going to a 50% split between the Lions Club Charities and the Warwick Valley Teacher Association Scholarship.
Yeah, you know, big thing here, this game, the money funds the scholarships. You know, me and Drew, seniors, it's going to help out a lot of people. And we are very pleased with the high turnout here tonight.
Here we go.
Also very happy with the way the game's gone. This is way more fun than I could have possibly imagined.
Yeah, Coach Rico, you're telling crowd capacity, I believe, was 1,034 people.
1,034.
We have 100% exceeded that.
Yes. There are well over 1,000 people.
Yeah.
It is really hot in this gym, especially for the people playing, and the amount of bodies in here is a reason why. So now some light pressure being applied. Putnam with the ball. Guarded by Arvanites. Inside. And Mackey got the steal. Oh. No, he was out of bounds.
Unlucky, unlucky.
There we go. You hadn't said unlucky all night. It's not a Drew Boyner broadcast without the word unlucky.
That might be my word.
That is definitely
I'm
going to
trademark
word.
That. That is my
you
word.
You should. Oh, and how about that? The one-handed grab by Mackey. And two-point game, minute and a half to play.
Big steal by Coach Garcia.
Garcia. Oh, Showtime Bob. And they couldn't finish it off. And a turnover. Sherman couldn't handle the pressure. Now, it's going to be a foul down low. And it will put, I don't know who is fouled there. I missed the shooter. It'll put someone at the line.
I don't think these refs like Coach O'Brien.
I don't think
all.
They do either.
I don't think they, because they're calling all the fouls. Whenever he gets a little physical when the guy goes up, it's always getting called.
Well, think about it. These refs are the same ones calling his games. He yelled with them nonstop during the season. Now they're taking it out on him. But the one thing I'll say about Coach O'Brien, he's very, very good at complaining to the refs without getting called for the technical.
Oh,
you see
yeah.
It, he draws that line massively. Like, they never tee him up, even though he says a lot. That's a skill he certainly possesses. 1-for-2 from the free throws. No. So now 45-49, minute 14 to play. Cats need an answer. Here's Sherman. O'Brien. Got stripped by Putnam. Now they're running the break. The throw, out, three-pointer, no good, that would have ended it. Rosa with the board, under a minute to play, four-point game, they need something and they need it fast. O'Brien, gonna drive, gonna get to Mackey. Coach Mackey, big-time high school player, he still has it. It's a one-point ball game. What a shot by Coach Joe Mackey.
That was crazy. I mean, that was a step back. Fadeaway three-pointer.
Just casually.
And he just casually just, it's like nothing for him.
big time players make big time plays. And now, with 43.1 to play, it's a 1-point ball game. What's the strategy here if you're the high schooler, Stu?
Give the ball to Coach Mackey, I would say.
Yeah.
But he's going to get probably quadruple teams.
This has been, look, I've never really watched an Ultamania game before. This has probably been the greatest one of all time because I can't imagine a game matching this energy.
Oh, yeah. I remember going to them as a kid. I just don't remember it to this extent. I don't think the crowd has ever been this big.
They are absolutely nuts. You know, 3 years it's been canceled because of COVID. I think everyone's just glad it's back. Wow.
43 seconds, let's go.
Here we go. They are moving. 40 seconds to play. They're going to set up a trap. This is promising. Can he hang on to the ball? He throws it. Yes, he can, right to Garcia, who puts his squad back up by three. 28 seconds to count, and they got to move. Here's Sherman. Is he going to shoot? No. He finds O'Brien. O'Brien, three-pointer. Does he have it? No. Rebound. Astorina. And now they got a foul. And the ref's on calling it. And now, finally, with 13 seconds, whistle sends the middle school teachers to Milan. Drew, that was a decent look from O'Brien.
Yeah.
I think you'd have to find Mackey, though, like you said. He should have been the one to take that shot.
Crowd getting into it now?
Yeah. This has been an incredible ball game. 48-51. And
Coach O'Brien still talking to the ref.
Yeah. Don't get cheated up here.
He's taking this so seriously, and I love
he
it.
He is.
Amazing.
Yeah.
He does not want to lose. Coach Kelly getting a little fancy here at the free throw line.
He got it.
That's
to go.
The dagger.
What?
That's Rudy. The dagger.
And it's a 4-point ball game. It's desperation mode now for the high schoolers after this shot. Like you said, I do love the motion. Free throw is up and good. He drained them both. Ice in his veins. And timeout called by Coach Armonite, trying to get his team a last-ditch attempt to win this ball game. And they are loud. We got a sign that says, "Let's go Putnam," with Mr. Putnam's face on it. I love that.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Love to see the community coming together like this for a basketball game. Hope to see this happen.
Coach O'Brien drawing up a play right now.
Yeah.
With Coach Mackey.
Yeah, I mean, look, the two best coaches in the district, if you put their efforts together, they got to be able to put up a scoring play, right?
Yeah, definitely.
There's no way they don't. Yeah, coaching alone, we should be able to mount this comeback. Okay, so 13 seconds, 13.3 is what it's been paused on. And now it's going to be Sherman inbound. Some motion. Who's going to get open? It's going to be Mackey. Mackey lost it. Myers knocked it away. Mackey's on the floor. Mackey gets back up with it. 10 seconds and he's fouled. How about Mr. Myers on the defense? That was.
And I think perfect. They're calling a 1-1 for Coach Mackey.
Are
here.
They? Yeah. You cannot afford to miss these here.
I think they're giving him 3 free throws, too.
Are they?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
There is no rules in Ultamania basketball. We can do whatever we want.
We can. We just want a good game here.
Good song coming on for the last 10 seconds.
Yep. Everyone is into this. We got a Let's Go Radon sign. I'm reading through the crowd. This place is still packed even in the fourth quarter. First free throw is up. It's good.
Okay, guys. We're going to need it really quiet. So Coach Mackey has a chance to focus on his shot.
Now Coach Rico tells everyone to be quiet, and they ignore him. Oh, you gotta love it. No respect whatsoever for Coach Rico. And now Mackey likes the noise, and it doesn't matter. Ice in his veins, too. Now with 10 seconds, they didn't even start the clock. It's going to be a foul and another 1-1.
Wow. Yeah, that was funny. Coach Mackey always talked about, in my years playing basketball, you know,
this kind of fundamentals and his shooting stroke, when he was just, he was demonstrating everything. I mean, he wouldn't miss a single free throw.
Yeah.
I've never seen him miss.
It's loud, Drew. I can barely even hear what you're saying.
Yeah.
But look, I mean, Coach Mack, he was one of the best point guards we've had in our history of Warwick basketball. He's just done incredible things as a coach, and now you see him showing that he still has it out on the court. Now, 6.6 seconds to play. Three-point game, they need a miss. The shot's up. It's no good.
Oh, wow.
Lane violation against the middle school.
They're calling a shoot. Coach Patafio, his foot hit the line when he hit the free throw.
And now that's going to advance the ball off the timeout for the high school team. 6.6 seconds down, three. You need a shot. And this is insane.
I just noticed it was a three-point game. I thought it was like a five-point game.
Wow. Almost everyone on their feet. It all comes down to this.
I think the plan here is just to give the ball to Coach Mackey.
Right. Just let him cook.
He's the only one who can make the three-pointer. Mr. Panessi's injured. He was telling me that at halftime.
Okay.
The charge he took that somehow did not get called, he hurt his elbow. So he might be out of commission for
Mackey's
a little bit.
Mackey's going to inbound. I'm assuming we're going to get some screen action and get it back to Coach Mackey. There's got to be something big drawn.
Yeah, interesting to see why Mackey's taking the...
Now it's... O'Brien got fouled on the three.
Wow.
O'Brien is going to have three free throws.
I think that's three. That has to be three. And they're signaling the three.
Yes.
Wow.
The middle school teachers do not like it. They say he was on the line. But Coach O'Brien will have a chance to tie up this ball game with 3.7 seconds to play. No pressure on Coach here.
Oh, he misses it. And he misses it.
How do you miss that? Second free throw now. Oh, my goodness.
Game over.
You need an intentional miss now, and then you got to throw it out. This is not a good way to end it.
See what Coach O'Brien does here.
Intentional miss.
Oh!
Can they get it? No.
Oh,
and they're
going to
throw. Wait, that's going to be a turnover, I think.
Oh, game over.
No, game over. They're storming the court. There's no way they're going to keep playing this. It was a missed free throw. He threw it up. It should have been a turnover. Who cares? And
that's amazing.
Middle school teachers are going to get mobbed. Buzzer sounds. Storming the court here at the Mai. Love to see it. What a game.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun covering this. Definitely a new experience for the both of us, something we haven't done. But, you know, it was a great time. Great cause for everyone coming out. You know, thank you for everyone coming out to this game, supporting it. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, we had so much fun covering this. We've had so much fun covering basketball all year and athletics in general. We'll be back with some more coverage. We hopefully will be filming a girls' flag football game in a couple months, and that'll be an experience. But it doesn't get better than this. You know, covering basketball in a packed gym. Everyone had so much fun today. One of the best school events I've seen for in a while. And any final thoughts, Drew?
It was a great game. You know, a lot of the teachers had a lot of fun, you can tell. Very physical, I'll say that. That was probably the most surprising thing from tonight, how physical the game was. So.
This was real basketball. There was nothing
It was real basketball.
They were giving their all out there. Mr. Tolman high-fives after going over eight for the field. It was such a great game. That being said, that'll do it for our coverage. For my whole production team, did a great job. We had a handheld camera. That was absolutely incredible. And Drew Warner had so much fun calling basketball the interview. I'm Vito Fernandez, wishing you all a great night.